Okay, this will be part two. The other one just went over a few seconds, over 10 minutes, you know, because of YouTube's bullshit policies and all that. I want to keep it so you can get the entirety of the video. So this one, I won't go quite 10 minutes, but it'll be more than a couple minutes. But I do have a little piece of property. I shouldn't say I have. I'm renting a piece of property where I'm able to grow a garden where a chicken coop used to be, where the ground is supposed to be really fertile. Last year I started and everything did pop up, and it came up really fast and pretty big, and then some major challenges have popped up in my personal life, and I pretty much, anybody who saw my videos before, I deleted everything off my computer, and it was really bad. So, but I had a lot of stuff on there, and a lot of it was non-sequential, and it just really, it was a bad time. Let's put it at that and let it go, okay? But I'll be doing the garden more this year, this spring. It is March 13, 2013. It is now 8:09 a.m. Central Time. And on this video here, I'll do a brief video of what it looks like outside where the garden is. And I'll explain a little bit about a tiller I was given by a guy who we had bought a vehicle from on faith. And we asked questions about certain things that were questionable. They should have been, they were red flags actually, and we were asked questions about it, and they denied it, and then the van just locked up because of the water pump went out, and they said it was probably a leaky hose and not having mechanical experience, even though I had mechanical again. He said, well, I wouldn't trust it because it looks like it had stop leak in it, blah 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 blah, and they kept insisting that, which is a bunch of bull. I mean, I'm not stupid, I know what stop leak looks like, and it was on the top of the radiator, but we needed a vehicle. It was like kind of like we were between a rock and a hard place, and we got it anyway, and then we were just stuck. We were suckers. You buy a used car, generally you're going to buy somebody else's problems. You got to investigate the vehicle thoroughly. That's why they have all that stuff with the Carfax and stuff like that. But anyway, maybe out of guilt or whatever, guy gave us an older tiller, pretty old tiller. He said it was his mom's, and she passed away, and he had it for like 3 or 4 years sitting. But it worked, he said. Last time it ran, it worked. There was no problem. And luckily, I don't know if it was his idea or if it was purpose, it had turpentine in the gas tank to kind of keep it from freezing up while it sat for 3 years or so. How many years it sat. I finally got it running, and I used it to break up some ground on the garden, which I'm going to show you on this video. And like I say, it wouldn't work, and there were other problems. I even had my brother come over, and he did basically what I did, and we just kept putting starter fluid in the breather, kept constantly saturating it to break through all the muck, which is what I did originally to get it running to begin with, and it's running again. So, but we're waiting for it to dry up and warm up enough to use it. So I'll just show you the garden and whatnot for now, what it looks like. So I'm going to pause this, and it'll appear on the garden. Okay, that's the garden out here. It's east at that end, west at this end, north over there, and I'm on the south end of it. So the side is the south. That's my mom's swing before she passed away. Anyway, I always like to try to swing here. This summer, our garden. Dedicating the garden to my mother, Mary Elizabeth Sarnick. She used to be called Shorty. So I'm going to put a plaque up on the end of the garden here. Right after I plant everything I can. As you can see, I took this tiller and got it running. Brought it down about one width of the tiller to the end here. Can't really see it good. You see the grass I killed off here. I did about half a width of the tiller in there. And I'm going to come all the way to the dead of the grass over there. I already did a one and a half on this side. I'm going to even it out even more. Oh, crap, I hate when they have tight all the way and then it just drops. Let me go to the east end of the garden. But over here, this is the west, I mean the north side of the garden, the north side. You can see, like I said, you see the white grass, that's the dead grass. That's going to be, I'm going to till it out right about there. About half of this is going to be tilled. I want to make my compost bin right here. I try to do everything as much as possible natural. Now, I'm going to get boards. I'm going to get some 2x4s to build like a little fence around it, three-sided, and I can top on it with a 4x6 plywood sheet. And I just, like I said, I just do everything by hand as much as possible. It's hard too, but see, I just dug that little line with a hole, a pointed hole. But I marked it out over here. I thought to extend the garden over here. So I'm gonna have like it's gonna be like an L. This little area right here, where my shadow is even, is gonna be dug up. You can see just barely the mark of this little stick. It was a tomato stick that I broke down. If I can find it in the viewfinder, I can't see anything out here when I'm out here. Where is it at? I'm looking at it right there. See that tomato stick? I broke it into three pieces, actually, or four pieces. And I got one there. And then it goes across to the garden, the main garden. And then over here at the corner of the garden, right there is one. And this one over here is bad time. I think I almost broke it. Where is it at? Now let me zoom in on it if I can find it. Right there. See, I was branched a little bit, broke. But it's gonna be like an L, like a giant L. But let me get over here to the main garden. Now with the tiller working, as soon as this dries up a little bit, because right now it's all muddy, pretty much. Oh gosh, I don't mind, the lens is either dirty or something. It looks like it's sun shining on it, but the sun's behind me, east coming up. And it's about 45 feet. And dogs don't mind about running across mud. But anyway, it's about 45 feet. I'm gonna do the exact measurements too. And put it out so I'll know what they are. And then I'll have a plaque at that end of the garden dedicated to my mother, Mary Elizabeth, quotation mark, Shorty Cernick. So this will be her garden for this year. And I'm sure, I'm positive this thing is gonna grow big time. Only with heirloom seeds though, everything will be heirloom. And then around the house I'm gonna have a few tomato and pepper plants also growing. So that's why I want you to see. You know, a tiller is the world of difference. I did probably 90% of this garden I did by hand with a hoe. I mean, it was hard. I did little pieces at a time, which I have on the Ozzy Man 1203 channel. You can watch. Cussing a lot of times too, because I get sidetracked when I see the sprayers up in the sky poisoning the skies even more. But yeah, I did most of this by hand, and then I got that tiller to work a little bit, and I did it around the edges, basically about 1.5 widths of that tiller all the way around the garden. And then it died out of gas, and then I just had so much clogged up in there still until my brother insisted, reinforced what I believed. And we got it started again by using starter fluid to clean out more of the gunk. So it should start later tomorrow or the next day, probably Friday. Thursday or Friday I might get it out here. Today is what is today? Shit, the 13th. I think today's Wednesday. So probably Friday and then the Saturday. I'll do the rest of this garden if it doesn't rain. So get yourself some food, some seeds, preferably heirloom. The wind is blowing. I'm sorry if you can't hear everything I'm saying. Get some heirloom seeds and try to plant a few things around the house. If anything, get 5-gallon buckets from places. Clean them out real good. Get yourself some food, some real food, not the crap you're buying in the store right now. They've lied about the radiation from Fukushima now for 2 years, and people are dying of cancer and everything else over there. So come on, people, stop pretending that it's not happening. It is happening. Stay safe. Take care of your family.